Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Donson from tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Adobe Illustrator tutorial, where today we're going to cover three different methods for doing this blended floral borderline geometric design. I'm not necessarily sure what to call it, but I stumbled across this effect actually here on YouTube. Saw some other people doing it and thought, whoa, that's so stinking cool. Got to give it a shot. So I came up with three different techniques that are kind of my own rendition of it, and I just had to share them with you. So that's what this tutorial is all about. I think you're really going to love it. If you do love it, make sure you hit that subscribe button, subscribe to my channel so you never miss any past, present, or future Illustrator tutorials. With that out of the way, let's jump in and check this thing out. All right, so like I said, I saw this tutorial on some videos here on YouTube. I'm going to make sure I link those videos down in the description so you can check them out as well. Give those guys some love because without them, I probably wouldn't be here making this video right now. So here we are in Illustrator. Got a blank document. I sized my document 2560 by 1440. And I am going to kick things off by canceling out the fill, by selecting the fill and hitting the slash icon over in the tool panel there. Then I'll use the black stroke for my shape. So that's the important thing here. Just that stroke, and we can leave it black for now. That's fine. I'm going to grab my ellipse tool, and I'm going to click once, and I'm going to choose to size this ellipse at 7 pixels by 7 pixels. Then I'm going to set the stroke for the little ellipse to 10 points, and then I'm going to grab the star tool. I'm going to click once, and I'm going to set my radius 1 and radius 2 to 125 and 65, and choose to make a star with 10 points. I'll then click to add another star. Don't worry about all the alignment. We'll get to that in a second. Click to add another star, and this one is going to have a 200 and a 150 radius. And this star also 10 points. So next, we're going to select all three of these shapes we just made. We'll open the Align panel window, Align, and choose to align to the artboard first and foremost. That's important. And then align these shapes both vertically and horizontally. Next, I'll grab my selection tool. I'm going to select the outermost star, and I'm going to hold down the Command or Control key and use those little white dots that appear. See them? I'm going to drag them inward a little bit just to round off the points of the stars a bit. And I'll repeat that process here for the inner star as well. This gets us set up nicely for what's about to come. Now I'm going to select the outer stroke here and open my gradient panel and apply a radial gradient and drag the leftmost handle, I'll drag it into around the 75% mark, and then I'm going to change the color to a pale yellow using the color panel. I'm going to set the color panel to RGB and choose the color here, and then I'm going to set the right hand color stop to more of a salmonish color. I'm going to leave the right hand stop over there at 100% positioning. After I do that, I'll select the second star, and I'm going to add a radial gradient here as well. I'll drag the leftmost handle into about the 50% mark, and this one I'm going to set to a deep magenta pink color using the color panel in the RGB mode, and I will select the right-hand color stop. I'll change that to like a nice light pink, again, using RGB up in the color mode, and maybe I'll even drag it inward to about the 85% mark, something around there. Then I'm going to select the little ellipse in the center and sample in that same gradient and flip the colors. So I'll sample that in using the eyedropper tool. I'm just going to flip those colors, and I'll adjust the gradient until I see a good gradient across this sort of fat stroke, right? We gave the ellipse and the stars this really thick stroke so we could help see this gradient a little bit more. So once I see the gradient across this fat stroke, I know I kind of have this in the right place. Next, I'll select all three strokes, and here, we're done. We don't need to see these huge strokes anymore, so we'll reduce the stroke to 1 point, a nice, thin, slender stroke. Then I'm going to go Object, Blend, and I'm going to choose Blend Options first, and I'm going to choose Specified Steps from the dropdown and blend it with 300 steps. Next, make sure I still have the three strokes selected. Go Object, Blend, Make. So we've got this crazy gradient object going on now. I'm going to select this entire blend now, and I'm going to go Effect, Distort and Transform, Pucker and Bloat, and I'm going to lay a big bloat, like 75%, plus 75% on this thing. Then I'm going to go back to Effect, Distort and Transform, and choose Zigzag. I'm going to go with 21 pixels in size. I'm going to choose Absolute, and I'm going to go with a 7 ridge per segment option, and I'll smooth the lines to create this effect here. Now, just beware, this is a little processor intensive, so it may take a couple seconds before you see your finished effect. Don't worry. But at this point, the effect is going to be finished. You can add a background to this graphic. You could tweak the colors, bring it over into Photoshop, adjust the color, and tweak white balance and all kinds of stuff a little bit more if you like. But the effect, as it is going to be made in Illustrator, is done. This is the first of these sort of floral blended color flower effects. So on to the next. Here again with another blank document, 2560 by 1440, we're going to add a 140 pixel by 140 pixel ellipse just by clicking a single time and setting it to 140 by 140. I'm going to give this a 10 point stroke again, no fill. and we'll add a star shape above this ellipse, and just click to add the star shape. Again, we'll go 150 by 75, or 150 and 75 for the two radius, and for this star, we're going to go 12 points. Then we'll add a third star. Sounding familiar here, isn't it? We're going to go 450 for the first radius, 250 for the second radius. Again, 12 points for the star as well. Now I'm going to grab all three of these shapes. Again, use the align panel, get them all lined up vertically, horizontally, in accordance with our artboard. Now I'm going to use the selection tool. Once again, hold down my command or control key, drag those little white dots in. We're going to do this for both stars. The key here is that I'm really looking for those outer stars to be long and thin stars, but just very slightly rounded corners. Select the outer stroke shape, and to this we're going to add a radial gradient with a color stop on the left set to a very pale, like yellow/pink color. I don't know how to describe it. And then the right color stop we're just going to set to a straight pale pink. Then I'm going to drag the left color stop into about the 75% point. I'm going to grab the inner stroke here, and I'm going to add a radial gradient to this with the color stop to the left set to a hot pink, and then I'll change the right color stop to a slightly brighter, hotter pink. Also using the color panel, which, by the way, I'm setting the color panel to RGB. You can really use any of the modes here as long as you have access to color, HSB, CMYK. They'll all work for you. I'm going to drag the left color stop in this gradient to 50%, and the right color stop, I'm going to slide it into 75%. Next, I'll select the ellipse in the center, and I'm going to add a radial gradient once more. Here, I'm going to change the left color stop to just a very pale yellow, and I'll change the color stop on the right to a hot pink. And then I'm going to swing the left color stop over to about the 70% mark, so shift it way over there. After that, I'm going to select these three strokes. I'm going to reset them to 1 point using the stroke panel. And I'll use that same set of blending options we set before. So I can just go Object Blend Make. It's going to apply the same 300-step blend that we used on our first floral and roll with what we get. The real key when you're working with artwork like this is getting the color right. If you get the color right, you can really make some cool stuff. So spend a little bit of time tweaking and adjusting the color. If you don't quite get it right, go ahead and play with the color a little bit more, and then go ahead and try making your blend again. So now that you have this, go ahead and select the whole blend and go Effect, Distort and Transform, and choose Pucker and Bloat. We're going to bloat this just a little bit to like 15%. Then I'm going to go Effect, Distort and Transform, Zigzag. And for this one, I'm going to set the zigzag to 15 pixels, absolute, with three ridges, and just select smooth, not corner. We'll go ahead here and we'll create another ellipse, 175 by 175 pixels, and I'm going to fill it with a radial gradient that goes from a flat pink on the left color stop, and select the color stop on the right and make this one like a deep, dark, saturated pink, very hot, very magenta pink, and adjust that flat, lighter pink stop to flood the middle of the flower with more of that pink like we did with the last one. So I'm taking this ellipse, I'm making sure that I'm aligning it to the very center here of this floral-looking shape that we're working on. And as we did before, we can add a background to this. We can take this bad boy into Photoshop or wherever, have some fun tweaking the colors and contrast tones, just as we see fit, have a little bit of fun with it. And once you're finished with that, let's go ahead and get after the next one. For the third and the final of these floral blended flower artwork designs that we're going to create, once again, I'm going to begin with a blank 2560 by 1440 document. I'm going to add a star here, 400 for the first radius, 150 for the second radius with 18 points. This is like an extreme star. Then I'm going to select the star and use the selection tool, hold down my command or control key, and use the dots to round the corners. And for this star, we don't need to worry about stroke. In fact, we don't want stroke. We're just dealing with a fill. So we're going to apply a radial gradient, and I'm going to set the left color stop to sort of this toasted brown color. I'm going to add a point in the middle here. I'm going to set that to this bright, fiery orange. And then I'm going to change the rightmost point to this very bright but pale sort of yellow color. And then I'm going to move the left point to the 65% mark, and the middle point, I'm going to shift it over to the 85% mark here on my gradient. Then I'm going to go Edit and choose Copy, and then I'm just going to choose Edit Paste in Front. This essentially is going to duplicate the star, paste it exactly in place. But here, with the front star selected, I'm going to look to my Properties panel, and I'm going to lock the Width and Height proportions, and I'm going to set one of the sizes here to 20 pixels. Then I'll use the Align panel to line these shapes up horizontally, vertically, and apply the same type of blend that we've been using before by going Object, Blend, Make, to apply that same blend to just these two star shapes. Then I'll go ahead and I'll select this whole blend. I'm going to use that same Pucker and Bloat, so we're going to go Effect, Distort and Transform, Pucker and Bloat, and I'm going to pucker this thing negative 30%. So we're going to go opposite the way we've been going for the rest of this tutorial. Then we're going to go Effect, Distort and Transform, and choose to roughen. And we're going to roughen this thing up to 30%. I'm going to choose Relative, we're going to go 0 for Detail, and we're going to set this thing to Smooth. You can see this crazy, it's almost like a shag carpet floral effect. It's kind of cool. And that's basically it for this flower. It's very simple. And like we did before, we can add a background, we can take the graphic into Photoshop, play with the color, the tone, you name it, wherever, whenever, however we want, to our heart's delight. And ladies and gentlemen, that's pretty much going to be it for this one. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, if you did create this flower, make sure you upload it to Instagram. Tag me. My Instagram handle is @tutvid. Actually, tag me in the photo, not just the description. If you drop the tag in the photo, it shows up in my tagged photos, and I'll never miss it. I'll eventually get to you. If you just tag me like in the caption, it's in my notifications. It's here today, gone tomorrow, and then I can't find it again. So make sure you do that. I would love to see what you guys are creating. I'll make sure I slap a like on it. I'll get in there, drop you a comment, show you, dap you up a little bit. That's what I'm trying to say. Again, my Instagram handle is @tutvid. You can check it out. I try to post some stuff over there, live streams, the whole bit. It's all good. All right, so for this tutorial and for the blend tool and just kind of everything that we did in this, all that roughing and all the distort and transform and just all that stuff, for all that and more, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.